which is not what's in your bulletin or up here. It's not 402, it is 403. Same page, but it's at the bottom of the page, 403. And I wanted to share with you in the lesson that I read, it says, a branch cannot bear fruit by itself. It reminded me that yesterday I was reading an article about longevity out of Time Magazine, and one of the articles was on, do church people live longer? The answer is yes, but it has less to do with your faith than it does with being in community. Believers who come to church in community live longer. So I enjoy all the chit-chat and the talking and the hugging and all of that, because that is what our Lord would have us be and do. So, the Lord is risen. Let us begin then with confession and forgiveness. Please rise if you may, if you can. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. We confess that we are captive to sin and cannot free ourselves. We have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us. Forgive us, renew us, and lead us, so that we may be light in your will and walk in your ways, to the glory of your holy name. Amen.
God, who is rich in mercy, loved us even when we were dead in sin, and made us alive together with Christ. By grace you have been saved. In the name of Jesus Christ, your sins are forgiven. Almighty God, strengthen you with power through the Holy Spirit, that Christ may live in your hearts through faith.
Amen.
God, you give us the Son as the vine, apart from whom we cannot live. Nourish our life in his resurrection, that we may bear the fruit of love and know the fullness of your joy. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
Kim Jackson will be doing the reading.
Our first reading this morning is from Acts, chapter 8. An angel of the Lord said to Philip, "Get up and go toward the south to the road that goes down from Jerusalem to Gaza. This is a wilderness road." So he got up and went. Now there was an Ethiopian eunuch, a court official of the Candace, queen of the Ethiopians, in charge of her entire treasury. He had come to Jerusalem to worship and was returning home, seated in his chariot. He was reading the prophet Isaiah. Then the Spirit said to Philip, "Go over to this chariot and join it." So Philip ran up to it and heard him reading the prophet Isaiah. He asked, "Do you understand what you are reading?" He replied, "How can I unless someone guides me?" And he invited Philip to get in and sit beside him. Now the passage of the scripture that he was reading was like this. Like a lamb, he was led to the slaughter, and like a lamb, silent before its shearer, so he does not open his mouth. In his humiliation, justice was denied him. Who can describe his generation? For his life is taken away from the earth. The eunuch asked Philip, "About whom, may I ask you, does the prophet say this? About himself or about someone else?" Then Philip began to speak, and starting with this scripture, he proclaimed to him the good news about Jesus. As they were going along the road, they came to some water, and the eunuch said, "Look, here is water. What is to prevent me from being baptized?" He commanded the chariot to stop, and both of them, Philip and the eunuch, went down into the water, and Philip baptized him. When they came out of the water, the Spirit of the Lord snatched Philip away. The eunuch saw him no more, and went on his way rejoicing. But Philip found himself at Azotus, and as he was passing through the region, he proclaimed the good news all the towns until they came to
Caesarea.
The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Second reading is from 1 John, chapter 4. Jesus is the Son of God, and they abide in God. So we have known and believed the love that God has for us. God is love, and those who abide in love abide in God, and God abides in them. Love has been perfected among us in this, that we may have boldness on the day of judgment, because as he is, so are we in this world. There is no fear in love, but perfect love casts out fear. For fear has to do with punishment, and whoever fears has not reached perfection in love. We love because he first loved us. Those who say, "I love God," and hate their brothers or sisters are liars. For those who do not love a brother or sister whom they have seen cannot love God whom they have not seen. The commandment we have from him is this: those who love God must love their brothers and sisters also. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Christ.
He is risen indeed.
Annie was known for her strong faith and her boldness in talking about the Lord. She was known to stand on her front porch and, for the benefit of her atheist neighbor, shout, "Praise the Lord!" resulting in her neighbor shouting back, "There ain't no God!" When hard times set in, Annie stood on her porch and prayed, "Praise the Lord! Please, God, send me some groceries." Well, the next morning, she found a large bag of groceries on her porch, which caused her to shout, "Praise the Lord!" Well, on cue, her neighbor jumped out from behind the bush and cried, "Hey, don't give God the credit. I bought those groceries. God didn't." Annie laughed, jumped up and down, clapped her hands, and shouted, "Praise the Lord! Not only did God send me groceries, God made the devil pay for them." The following story is based on our reading from the book of Acts, and it is told from the eunuch's perspective. Man. with all its frustrations and anger and loneliness being swept away. And when he finally raised me up out of the water, I felt reborn. I was a brand new person, a whole person. I couldn't believe how bright the day looked, how warm the sunshine felt, how happy I was. I stood on the riverbank thanking this God that I had found, that had found me, praising this God who sent such a loving, accepting Messiah. I knew that my life had changed. I was different. I'm sure it was still the same old body of which I've been so ashamed. But I wasn't ashamed anymore, because I knew God loved this body of mine, loved me as I am, loved all of me, unconditionally. Oh, Philip, thank you, I exclaimed, but as I looked around, I saw that he was no longer there. I looked up and down the road, but he was gone, and it didn't matter. I almost flew back to the chariot. Hurry up, everyone, let's get home as fast as we can. I've got some wonderful news to tell everyone. The Lord is risen.
He is risen indeed.
And he loves you.
Thank you.
God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Our offering, our ushers are Connie Singleton and Carol Clays. Kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not to temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord's face shine on you with grace and mercy. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace.
Amen. Our service. Our pastor, Pollock, was gone this weekend. Carol Gesselman was our guest pastor. St. John's is located at 27 North Wittenberg Avenue, Springfield, Ohio. Our telephone number is 937-323-7508. The flowers on the chancel stand are given to the glory of God.